factors and remainders, n is a number which belongs to positive integers and it is greater than 1. So n starts from 2. N can be 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on, right? We have to find the largest number by which this expression is divisible, and you have been given options. So this means amongst these, which number always divides this expression, right? N into 2n plus 1 into n square minus 1 into n square plus n. So the first step is, I have expanded this, n into n square minus 1 calculated as n minus 1 into n plus 1. So n minus 1 into n into n plus 1. So this is the product of three consecutive integers, right? The other term, n square plus n, can be written as n into n plus 1. And then you have another one, that is 2n plus 1. So these two come together, right? Now, one way of solving this is by putting values. I'll come to it later. The other way is to look at the expression itself and try to understand what will be the necessary factors of this expression. Let's see. If n is even, this n is also even, this is odd, this is odd, this is odd, and this is odd, right? So you will get two even numbers, which means this expression will be divisible by 4, 2 into 2, 4, right? If n is odd, then this becomes even, also this becomes even, which means again this expression has to be divisible by 4. So the first thing which is understood is this expression is always divisible by 4. Alright? So look at the options. 9, 15, they are not divisible by 4. 18 is not divisible by 4. 36 is 4 into 9. So yes, this is divisible by 4. So now I try to check, answer will be 36 if this expression is also divisible by 9. Right? What is 9? 9 is 3 square. So let me check whether this expression will be always divisible by 9 or not. Now to check divisibility with 3, you have to take first case, let's say n is a multiple of 3. Second case can be n is 3 plus 1. Third case can be n is 3x plus 2. There cannot be any other case because next will be 3x plus 3, that will again be divisible by 3. So it will again be 3x. Right? So you need to take 3 cases. In the first case, if n is 3x, that is n is divisible by 3, you have 2 n's, right? So n square will be divisible by 9 automatically? Yes. 9 are there, so. Next case, if you take n as 3x plus 1, n minus 1 becomes 3x. So n minus 1, so you are getting 1 3x, right? We need to check for another 3. Look at 2n plus 1. 2n plus 1 will be 2 times 3x plus 1 plus 1, which means 6x plus 3, which is 3 times 2x plus 1, again divisible by 3. So you have 1, 3 and another 3. So again this expression is divisible by 9. Got the logic? I am repeating. If n is 3x plus 1, this becomes 3x and this one becomes 6x plus 3. So you again get 2 terms which are divisible by 3. So it is divisible by 9. Next one, 3x plus 2. If you take n as 3x plus 2, n plus 1 becomes how much? 3x plus 3, which is again divisible by 3, and n plus 1 comes 2 times. So this will get squared, getting it? So 3 square will give you how much? Again 9, which means this expression is again always divisible by 9. So divisible by 4, divisible by 9, this expression will always be divisible by 36. This is an important method for such questions, very important for CAT. Alright? Alternatively, people work through such questions by taking 2-3 options. Having said that, that's not a very concrete method. This one is the one you should focus on more. Let's look at the other one. Check for values. In the other method, first take n is equal to 2. Sabse chota value wahi ho sakta hai. So if n is equal to 2, this expression will put curve 1 into 2 into 3 into 2 into 3 into 5. Right? Dekho, 3 square 9, 9 4 jump, 36 मल्टीपल आ गए 5 वाला में, तो 36 का मल्टीपल है, गॉट इट। लेकिन ऐसे केस में एक से नहीं होगा, यू नीड टू टेक टू थ्री वैल्यूज, क्योंकि हमेशा होगा ये जरूरी नहीं है, क्योंकि तुमने एग्जांपल लिया है, ठीक है। take n is equal to 3, when you take n is equal to 3 you will get 3 into, sorry, you will get, I'm looking at this expression, 2 into 3 into 4 into 3 into 4 into 7, again 9 hai aur 4 hai, again division by 36, you take another value and then you can be sure by taking 3 values that the number is always divisible by 36. But this method is for those who do not know this one. For people who are experts who know such a method, they can easily look through this expression and say odd even, kitne se hoga, 4 se hoga, 2 se hoga. They can also look and say 3 ka multiple kaise hoga. This is a more sure method. A very important concept for CAT. I hope this is totally clear. Thank you.